Aloha. Before I show you how to use the tool called Tasks, Tests, and Surveys, and yes, it's one tool with a very long name, I first want to recommend that you check to make sure you're using the right web browser. Go to your Laulima homepage, the same one that you use to log in, and scroll down. Laulima Tech Support will usually provide a link to the latest web browser recommendation. My students have found out that using a browser other than the one that's recommended, and currently it's Firefox, means that they are not able to complete quizzes that I give to them in this tool. So make life easier on yourself and make sure you're using the recommended browser. After you log in, look for the tool in the left-hand nav bar called Tasks, Tests, and Surveys. Click on that, and you'll go to a page that looks like this. This page looks a little more complicated than what you would see when you're signing in for the first time, because Tasks, Tests, and Surveys keeps track of all the tasks, tests, and surveys that you've taken throughout the semester. The latest quiz is at the top. You can tell that it's ready to begin and it's not finished because the status says ready to begin, and it tells you what date the quiz is open and what date it will close. It gives you the time that the instructor has assigned to that, how many tries you can have, and when you start and stop it. Make sure you read the instructions, and that way you'll know what your faculty member has prepared for you. Notice that some quizzes require you to agree to this honor pledge. If you try to begin without agreeing to it, it's just going to send you back. So click I agree and then begin the test. Before we look at the questions, it's important that you understand the function of these five buttons on the top. The next button is simply going to take you to the next question. As you can see below, we're on question one. If you were to answer that, you'd move on to question two by clicking the next button. And if you were uncertain of number one or you wanted to check it, you'd click the previous button to go back. Clicking on the table of contents shows you what the general number of questions are and a little bit about each one in the whole test. Now the tricky ones are the continue later and the finish buttons. The continue later button does not pause the timer that you see ticking down. Continue later just takes the answers that you have previously put into your desktop computer and saves it to the server. Keeps ticking down. 55:30 right now. I'm going to click continue later. And you see I'm down to 55:22. The 8 seconds that kept going by wasn't paused. So this is good if you think your power is going out or something's calling you away from the computer, to make sure that at least as much work as you've done up to this point is saved to the server. When you actually want to finish the task, you would click finish. It's going to give you plenty of warnings so you can't do this by mistake. So you have to click this one. Your instructor has a number of choices as to what type of questions he or she puts into your quiz. Could be multiple choice, could be true-false, could be fill-in-the-blank, could be essay answers. A lot of times they will also provide a review for you after the quiz is over. Sometimes this review is available immediately when you're done. Other times it's not available until everyone's taken the test, and other times the instructor does not make this review available online. I think with this brief overview of the Tasks, Tests, and Surveys tool, you should be able to handle the tasks, tests, and surveys that come your way.